Hey guys, welcome to JPlays, I'm Iceman, and this is my playthrough of VIII, Lacrimosa of Dana for the PC. Now, finally, into Chapter 6. At the very beginning of Chapter 6.
How exciting.
What do you want to enhance?
Aura plants.
See you later.
Oh, that's right. You need it. The game did mention it about medicinal stuff. All right, let's get on with it.
Now let's fight elegantly.
Wow.
Let's go.
Turn now.
coming. Melody of
Whoa. Crazy. Two to go.
Squad struggling.
Wow.
Yes. Let's go.
The hell's that?
Just a little more. I'll join in. Believe in your weapons.
Good to go.
Is that all? That thing was way scarier than it looked. I mean, than it actually was. What? Exactly. We gotta find the source of them and take it out. Major Tower.
Help you today. Leave it to me. Whew, it's complete. You today. Is that it?
What?
Dear.
Oh man. Ah.
I prepared this tea just like how Laxia taught me. The aroma should be different. What do you think?
Yes.
Good! I feel so special now. Oh, I made you a necklace from the stone you gave me. It's just like mine. Now we'll match. You're on an owl. Allison taught me how to make it. It's my masterpiece. I'll put it on you right now. Hold still. Ta-da! Wow, that looks really great on you. No, thank you. I'm so happy I met everyone. You all know a bunch of stuff that I couldn't have learned from Father or my books. I can make new teas, cook new meals, do my own sewing, and use all sorts of tools now. I bet the outside world has all kinds of stuff for me to learn. Just thinking about what's waiting for me out there makes me so excited! Maybe, but I'm not sad at all. Even if we're both somewhere else, we can still see each other again if we try. I'll never forget what everyone taught me. I have so many family members now. It makes me feel all warm inside. If anybody in the family is ever in trouble, I'll zip over and help them out. By the way, Father says we're cut from the same cloth. I think that means we're both adventurers. So let's have a contest. Whoever sees more stuff than the other person wins!
Yeah.
Deal! Anyway, the first thing I'm gonna do when I get off this island is grow up and fill out. I'm talking ba-ba-boom! Mm-hmm. You better call dibs now before someone else does.
Help you today. Is that it?
Please take this. Please take this. Please take care.
Delicious. Man, am I stuffed. And I made plenty for everyone, too.
Yeah.
Same here. This island gives me the willies, but at least the fish are fat and tasty. If it weren't for all the primordials, this would be a perfect fishing spot. Shame the captain weren't with us to enjoy it, though. I decided, after I get off of this island, I'm gonna pay my respects to the captain's family. That man did a lot for us. Him and me, we got the same sea in our blood. Wouldn't be right not to tell his kin about what happened.
Then.
Thanks for that, Adol. Since we're talking about captains and all, that Captain Reed fella's been gnawing at me too. Falsely charged and dying alone, without ever seeing his family or crew again. Wish he had some descendants, so I could tell him the truth. Thinks they know ain't the only truth. Could be people out there what still believe in Captain Reed. All right. When I get back home, I'm telling the family all about what happened here. Everything I saw, everything I heard, everything. I'm getting fire in my belly just thinking about it. Here's to a great departure, Adol.
Yes.
Things may be calm now, but you never know when a primordial might appear. At all, do you believe we will survive this experience? I am relieved to hear you say that. At all. No, Sir At all. I apologize for my impertinence, but I must ask a favor of you. This situation is without precedent, and I will lay my life on the line to keep us safe. However, should the worst happen to befall me, please look after Mistress Laxia in my stead. But of course, from a young age, Mistress Laxia has always conducted herself with pride and demonstrated compassion and deference toward others. However, she struggles to put aside that pride and come to terms with her own inexperience. As her loyal servant, I find her impatience to be vexing and worrying in equal measure. But I believe the time will soon come when Mistress Laxia no longer requires my service. She has grown more wise, thanks to you. I believe her pride and determination will prove to be valuable assets to her now. And I believe she can overcome any hardship facing House Roswell. The future is promising indeed. Duly noted. You speak true. I cannot give up. However, there is something else that I still expect from you. Though it might be more fitting to say, you still have a responsibility to uphold. I see through your feigned ignorance. You are so much like Lord Roswell. In any case, I will continue to serve Mistress Laxia for the time being. Thank you for everything, Ella.
Let me see. Oh, great job. This is a special one.
Thank you.
Hey, a boat.
Treasure chest.
Magna Carpa.
Beautiful view.
No way. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Wow, he'll actually help? Monolith. What's that? What broken monolith?
Something there.
Excuse me.
thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
special. This one is special.
Help you today. Is that it?
Ooh. All status effects. That's good.
see. Say, Adol, do you know what coffee is?
Yes.
Oh, is that so? So this'll be your first time drinking it, huh? I can't wait to see your reaction. Well, go on, try it. Looks like you're not a fan of the taste. Just so you know, coffee's appeal is its bitter flavor. Ricotta can make a fine cup of tea, but every so often, I get a craving for coffee. It's definitely an acquired taste, but the more you drink, the more you'll come to like it. Anyway, coffee is made from beans that grow on a certain tree, a tree that is indigenous to the African continent. That coffee you're drinking is made from beans I acquired years ago. You sure perked up once I mentioned Africa. I might have mentioned it before, but I've spent many years researching Africa. I've even set foot in the southern region of the Sahara Desert. Impressive, huh? Anyway, I told you that story so I could tell you this. Before you can venture into unexplored lands, you need two things. Connections and a lot of money. Thankfully, I managed to secure funding and support from a certain noble associate of mine. 2 years back, we drafted a large-scale plan for an expedition to Africa. But during the early planning stages, I wound up stranded on the Isle of Sarin. The situation seemed hopeless at first, but exploring this island turned out to be much more enjoyable than I expected. And on top of that, meeting Ricotta was truly a blessing. At my age, I never expected to meet anyone I would care about so much. I've been running solo all my life, so having someone to look after feels different. I know I've said this to you before, but if I get off this island, I want to show Ricotta everything the world has to offer. That way, she can be an independent woman. There's a good chance Ricotta and I will end up seeing Africa together. Who knows? We might even run into you again, Adol. If that day comes, we'll catch up over a cup of coffee. Yes, I'm sure she'll have grown into a fine lady by then. So you better not go falling for her. At least not while I'm still alive.
Oh, God.
primordial population has definitely increased.
Huh? What's that? Something wrong?
Look down. The Great Tree of Origins.
That fog?
It doesn't look like the fog we saw with the ghost ship.
Yes, it's localized entirely around the Great Tree. It almost resembles a cocoon of sorts.
Has the Great Tree always been able to do that?
No, I've never seen it do this before. What's happening here?
Look at that!
It is the tree making him.
Primordials?
They look like the one that attacked the village. Those primordials predate the Eternian era.
How is that possible? Are you saying those primordials came from the fog?
We can't determine anything from up here, at all. Indeed. We have to do something about the Great Tree. Let's check in with the village before we go.
Overkill.
Let's go!
On guard! Yeah.
to me.
Strange. We should have reached the temple by now.
Huh. Did we miss it?
What are
are you saying? We couldn't have missed it.
Yeah. Hey, is the path supposed to be this long?
No. Something is clearly amiss here. I don't sense any Saurians. What's going on?
Only way we'll find out is if we keep moving.
Is everyone here?
Yes, we are.
Yeah.
I have a bad feeling about this. Everyone, be careful.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Interesting.
What's going on?
That's the thing that things got. Dana's got.
Why, that's the same symbol as Donna?
Just showed up out of the blue.
Why the hell does that all have it?
You received that exact same symbol after you fought a primordial in the fog. What? Everyone, look!
Fog surrounding the great trees, expanding.
What's going on?
The evolution of the world, begun anew by the great tree of origins. Something's coming from the fog.
That's the robed fellow we saw at the Valley of Kings. But who are the others? Gah!
Those people... they're monsters!
A thousand pardons for bewildering you. Let us begin by introducing ourselves. My name is Hydra.
I am Minos. Upon closer examination, you humans are far more frail looking than I had expected.
My name is Nestor. I do not require that you commit it to memory. Nevertheless, we are well met.
And I am Ura.
You are Adol, I presume. We wish you no harm.
Really?
I'm skeptical, but I suppose we should hear them out.
So who are you?
Selection and rejection. As I mentioned before, this process is the means by which the Great Tree fosters evolution. We are the Wardens of Evolution. Beings who have been tasked with overseeing that process.
Wardens of Evolution? What you said earlier, the evolution of the world begun anew by the Great Tree of Origins? What does that mean?
It is beyond your ken. The Lacrimosa has visited this world many times over the ages. That humans now claim dominion over this world will not forestall the inevitable.
You mean...
Exactly. The same fate that befell the Eternians will befall you. Humans have been rejected for the coming evolution.
What?
You mean we're all gonna die?
Unfortunately, yes. The Lacrimosa will bring forth a cataclysm, which varies in accordance with the era. The resurgence of the prehistoric world unfolding before your very eyes, that is, in fact, the Lacrimosa of this era.
Well, then the Great Tree needs to go.
Its effects are currently confined to this island, but in due time, it will spread across the world. So it has been decided since time immemorial.
So do I. How can you say we've been rejected when we don't even know the reason why?
These are understandable reactions. I sympathize with your plight, but there is nothing we can do.
Not once in the entire span of existence has a species thrived forever. By necessity, the species must be renewed to maintain the world.
Simply put, the Lacrimosa is the natural law of the world. All living creatures must accept its judgment.
No, not gonna happen.
What is it?
They all have the same symbol as Donna and Adol.
Indeed they do. What does that mean?
Donna? No.
It seems you've remembered. When the Lacrimosa comes, a single individual is selected from the species facing extinction. That individual will then witness the destruction of their own species. In doing so, the cycle of selection and rejection will be perpetuated for all eternity.
And all of a sudden, this game became like Mass Effect.
We, the Wardens of Evolution, are those chosen.
You, Donna, are the chosen warden of the Eternian era. It is only right that you be by our side.
Donna, then...
The symbol on your arm, Adol, is proof that you've been selected to be a warden. That is why we have come to greet you.
Why was Adol chosen?
Only the brightest soul among the species facing extinction is selected to become a warden. As the selected soul, you are beholden to this fate. Now cease your resistance and join us.
Not gonna happen.
No, we refuse to accept this.
What a pity.
They are merely overwhelmed by the gravity of our sudden revelation. Nothing more.
That voice sounds like David Hayter.
For now, we will take our leave of you.
You will see us again. Steel yourselves.
Until we meet again, Donna.
Wait!
Sure.
Over here, Donna. Olga!
I Alright, I'm gonna end this one here. As this video has gone very long. Let's see how long we've been going for. 2 hours. Damn. Okay, well, guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you'd like to be notified of when I go about putting up the next one, be sure to subscribe on the YouTube side of things, and then you'll be notified when that's made available. Alright, guys, have a good one.